Hi, Wayne here from Sears PartsDirect. Today we're going to talk about what to do when you see an F30 or F31 code on your range when you try to bake or broil. For Kenmore and Frigidaire ranges like this one, these codes mean that the control detects a problem with the oven temperature sensor probe. The three parts that can trigger this code are the oven temperature sensor probe, a wiring harness, or the electronic oven control board. The F30 and F31 codes differ slightly, even though they both indicate a problem with the oven temperature sensor. The F30 code means that the probe could be broken or unplugged, or its wires could be damaged. The F31 code is similar. It indicates the probe could be broken or its wires could be pinched. Pinching can damage the sensor wire's insulation, causing bare wire strands to short against each other or the metal cabinet. With both codes, if you find that the sensor probe and its wiring are okay, it means the control board incorrectly detected a bad sensor and you'll have to replace the board. This video shows how to figure out exactly what's wrong. You need a multimeter to complete the electrical checks and a nut driver to pull off the back range panels. Also, remember to let the oven cool to room temperature if it's still hot. Let's get started. Unplug the range and pull it out of the cabinet. If you have a gas range, shut off the gas supply. Remove the screws and pull off the top and bottom back panels. First, make sure the sensor probe is fully plugged into its wire harness. If the connection is loose, tighten the connection and reassemble the range. Restore electrical power to see if the code disappears. If it does, you fix the problem by tightening that wire harness connection. If the code appears, let's check the entire sensor circuit through the purple wires that connect to the control board. Unplug the wire harness with the purple wires from the control board. With your multimeter set to check resistance, measure the resistance through the purple wires on the connection plug. It should measure around 1080 ohms at room temperature. If you get near 1080 ohms of resistance, the oven temperature sensor probe and its wiring are likely okay. But you'll need to check for a ground to the metal cabinet, which can also cause an F30 or F31 code. Check for resistance from each purple wire to metal on the back of the range. If you measure 0 ohms of resistance between one or both purple wires and the metal cabinet, that means a damaged wire is creating a short. Find and repair the wire damage that's allowing bare sensor wiring to touch the metal cabinet. If you measure OL between each purple wire and the metal cabinet, there is no short and the wiring is okay. You'll need to replace the control board because you've ruled out all other possible failures. Take a look at our video, Replacing a range oven control board, for more help. Now, if you didn't measure near 1080 ohms through the purple sensor wires that connect to the control board, a broken oven temperature sensor probe or wiring failure is causing the F30 or F31 code. Let's check the sensor first. Unplug the sensor from the wire harness and check the sensor resistance by placing the meter probes into the harness plug. If you don't measure near 1080 ohms, replace the oven temperature sensor. Our video, Replacing a Temperature Sensor in Electric Range, will show you how. If you do measure near 1080 ohms of resistance through the sensor, replace the wire harness because it's keeping the control board from measuring the proper sensor resistance. Once you replace the problem part, reinstall the back panels and plug in the range. The error code should be gone. That means you fixed the problem and can get back to baking. I hope this video helped you out today. Check out our other videos here on the Sears PartsDirect YouTube channel. Subscribe and we'll let you know when we post new ones.